While it's not a rare disease, it's rarely diagnosed. That's because it mimics so many other diseases.
We're talking about Alpha-1 Anti-TRIP-sin Deficiency, also known as AAT deficiency. It's a genetic disorder that increases your risk for lung disease.
We traveled to Chicago to learn more from a renowned expert on the subject matter.
But first, meet a patient who was caught totally off guard by his diagnosis.
Difficulty breathing.
And 56-year-old Jay Whitmore is not a smoker, yet he was battling infections normally associated with smoking. His issues began in 2005 while on a hiking trip in the Dominican Republic.
Well, I was hiking with friends and my chest got very tight. I had a hard time breathing. I knew I'd had a little congestion. I felt like maybe I was getting sick, but I've never had that chest tightness and heavy feeling before.
So you don't have your doctors around, you don't ever feel these symptoms.
No.
So at that moment, you come back to the States and you do what?
Well, when I went to the physician, he diagnosed me with a bronchitis. He gave me antibiotics, and then that's when I asked for a chest x-ray. He called me 2 days later, the chest x-ray came back and said I had emphysema.
Emphysema?
Yes.
Surprised?
Totally surprised. There should be no reason why, you know, at 43 that I would be diagnosed with emphysema.
Dr. Kyle Hogarth, a pulmonologist at the University of Chicago, says that's a familiar reaction for many people, especially when they have no idea that alpha-1 deficiency runs in the family. Dr. Hogarth is an expert in pulmonary diseases, including alpha-1 deficiency, also known as AAT deficiency, which is a hereditary condition.
Alpha-1 deficiency is the name for a disorder where your body is not manufacturing enough of a specific protein. If you take a breath right now, you're breathing in a lot of different materials in the air, smoke and dust and pollens and bacteria and viruses. Those things land inside the lungs, your immune system takes over, it fights so that you don't get sick. Alpha-1 is what shuts off all of that destructive force. And if you don't have enough alpha-1 around, then all of these destroying enzymes are allowed to run free. And so you can imagine that one of the things that's gonna happen is a lot of excessive damage to the lungs because you can't regulate your body's response to anything foreign coming into the lungs. If you're walking around with not enough protective enzymes, but plenty of destructive enzymes, that imbalance leads to progressive damage to the lungs over time, or an accelerated damage to the lungs. So the way that manifests is frequently COPD and emphysema and asthma and bronchiectasis and bronchitis. You can pick a term, but the commonality here is damage to the airways and damage to the meat and substance of the lung.
Alpha-1 deficiency is a genetic condition passed from one generation to the next.
You're born with this deficiency. You inherited one abnormal gene from mom and one abnormal gene from your father. And the reason, of course, this is so relevant is that the carrier rate in the United States is actually quite high. And if you think about your own extended family tree and you realize how many families marry into your family tree just over 2 to 3 generations, you start to realize that there's a good chance that another carrier is gonna enter into your family tree somewhere.
As we mentioned earlier, alpha-1 deficiency is hard to diagnose because the symptoms mimic many other conditions.
People present with shortness of breath. They're coughing. They're having trouble with exercise or in simple exercises, you know, walking around. They may notice that they wheeze occasionally. And so what frequently does happen is they're told they have asthma. They're told they have COPD or emphysema or bronchitis. The problem is alpha-1 manifests as COPD or asthma and emphysema, something that an average physician sees several times a day, every single day. And alpha-1, the actual disease then, is buried in the noise, if you will. The disease manifests at all ages, across all races and ethnicities, and presents with multiple different obstructive type lung diseases that frequently a physician would prescribe an inhaler for. And in fact, the only way you're gonna make this diagnosis, you know, I can look at you and I can examine you and I can swear up and down that you have alpha-1 deficiency, but until I do the blood test, I have no idea if I'm correct or if I'm wrong.
Jay Whitmore was first diagnosed with lung disease in 2004, about 4 years later, and still no clue that he has AAT deficiency. Jay met with a pulmonologist and enrolled in a clinical trial for COPD. Something he read in a waiting room changed his life forever.
And as I was sitting at the table getting my pulmonary function test. When that finished, I was reading a magazine, and in the magazine there was an article on Alpha-1 Anti-TRIPSin Deficiency. I'd never heard of it. I tore out the card where you could order a free test, took the test, and it came back positive for Alpha-1 Anti-TRIPSin Deficiency.
You learned that it was genetic. Did you find out more about the family tree that would help kind of like figure things out for you?
Yes, my mother was a smoker, mm-hmm. so she has a little bit of COPD. I don't know if it's related to the Alpha-1, but my father, who's also a carrier, is asymptomatic. He doesn't have any symptoms at all.
Dr. Hogarth says there are some general recommendations on who should be tested to rule out Alpha-1 deficiency.
The key points are the following. It's anyone with the diagnosis of COPD, regardless of their smoking history. It's anybody with the diagnosis of emphysema, regardless of their smoking history. It's anybody with the diagnosis of chronic obstructed asthma. Clearly, people who have family members with the disorder should be tested. Bronchiectasis, otherwise unexplained liver disease, should also be another person who's tested. There's also a rare inflammatory condition of the skin and of the blood vessels. If you have those disorders, you should be tested. You'll notice over and over that the thing I kept saying is regardless of smoking history. If you've been labeled with one of these obstructed diagnoses and you're on inhalers for these medications, this is the test you need to rule out this disorder. Would it shock you to learn that the average Alpha-1 patient goes 8 years and has to see 3 separate doctors before someone orders a simple blood test?
The doctor also says that testing for Alpha-1 deficiency is not complex nor expensive.
It can obviously be done with any form of a blood draw, so think of every time you've been to the doctor's office and then they sent you down the hall or whatever and put the needle into your vein and tube or two of blood. Well, it's as simple as that. So anytime you've had your blood drawn, you could be tested for Alpha-1. We can do it even more simple though. It can actually be tested with just a simple poke to the finger and a few drops of blood from your fingertips. It can also be done for free. There's really no excuse.
And Dr. Hogarth says that for certain patients that have a severe Alpha-1 deficiency with emphysema, there's a treatment available for that as well.
For the correct patient, the management of this disease involves replacing the deficient protein. So you don't make enough. So what if we could put it back into you? So once a week, you receive an injection, an infusion of the purified protein that you're missing, so that we can raise your levels back up and try to normalize the levels of your Alpha-1 protein since you don't manufacture enough. And of course, the alternative, not treating the disease you have, how's that an option?
Jay Whitmore followed his doctor's advice and modified his lifestyle. He actually moved from Atlanta to Florida. He says because there's less pollution there.
How is Jay today?
I'm a lot better. My lung function still continues to drop. But, I take care of myself. I'm pretty healthy. I don't let it really bother me too much. I still try to
exercise. Still active?
Very active. I ride my bike. I walk every day, go to the gym. So, yeah, and I try to travel and do things. I mean, I do have my limitations, such as altitude or smoggy cities. But other than that, everything's been going pretty good.
So there is life after solving this puzzle?
There is life after solving the puzzle.
And for more information on Alpha-1 deficiency, you can visit ruleitout.org or just go to our website, thebalancingact.com.
And coming up, making sure you're covered when life throws you those unfortunate curveballs.